Happy Saturday. I'm glad everyone is staying warm and the pipes didn't freeze or power didn't go out or anything like that. So I knew we would have like a ton of people today just because it sucks out, like horribly. And so I want to go over a couple things we looked at last week. We want to look at this GoCo and Friends show that we started on Wednesday. But also give some time for things that, you know, what you guys, you know, think that we've gone over the last, you know, couple months that you want to look at some more or think about questions. So think about that as we go along. We'll take the second half of class to kind of just look at that, okay? So let's kind of start with where we left off. Actually, we left off with this Friends show. You guys are pretty closely, Matt, you've seen this before. This is from Kagayoshi View. Many disturbances are very disturbed. All right, and it looks like a very basic concept right from the outset, but just like all of them, they always look basic, and then you start digging down to it, and there's like a whole level of like complexities and things that are going on. So we got Matt over here, and so Matt's coming out with this right kind of lunging grab right in here. I'm going to move off to the side, which is right here, right down the center. Okay. Once we get here, I'm actually going to, you know, change from that punch to maybe grabbing into his throat or into his gi, and I'm just going to move out there. As you guys experienced on Wednesday, that step is not easy.
Mr. White. Yeah. You're doing that step so fast. Oh, could you?
I can.
To these eyes.
Yeah. I'll do it. I'm getting down in the center. That's perfect. Remember, this is a pull. Pulling him into this fist, not punching him and grabbing on the arm. So that's the first thing. So let's really concentrate on that. So I'm pulling Matt. All right. Pulling this. So I just happen to be the Hendo Kamae. My fist is right there. All right. I'm not doing this. Poof. Now I could. All right. Totally different pocket. Pulling him into the fist, getting him leaning back. All right, putting the fist. Now, from here, then grabbing on. I want to keep Matt in this limbo position. All right, if I step out and I go like that, Matt's automatically out of it. All right, so I have to find a way to keep him here as I go over here. All right, which means I have to change the way that I'm applying pressure to him. So if I'm pulling this and pushing this, all right, I have pressure coming this way, pressure coming this way. All right, think of it as I'm on a clock, and like, this is going to 12, this is going to 6. As I step out to the side, this kind of needs to go to 2 while this goes to 7. Almost like a bug. Feel I'm kind of pushing and pulling you? That keeps you in position. If I don't do that, you'll step right out of it every single time. So that's one of the keys to this thing, is keeping this pressure in this E hand. So as I step out with this Yoko Ruki, I'm gonna change the pressure. So instead of going this way and this way, it's gonna be going this way and this way. So then, I can work. Okay? You've seen this one before? Feel comfortable with it? Understand it?
Okay? Well,
it's gonna be a couple of years.
A little bit.
Oh yeah, you wanna?
Yes, yeah, sure.
Lunge. So lunge, punch, pulling to here. Okay. Now, please also note, if Adam's punching you on this line, I want you to watch where his arm ends in the end. Here. Perpendicular to the line that he was punching in. All right. I'm an E-hen. So I'm going to feel this push and this pull going on right now. I'm going to grab him here, grab him here. I'm going to change the pressure.
Oh, yeah.
So now it's being pulled out this way, push this way, so you stay in the same place. So I have to adjust the pressure to adjust for my movement. And then, okay. I'm always constantly keeping this at the zenith of torque. Once I get it here, it's always constantly at the zenith of torque. I'm not letting it up a little with the shoulder. Okay? If you feel comfortable starting, you guys want to do it? Alright, okay. So you're gonna come in with that bit. Exactly. So you have to go right down this line. So here, sorry. I'm gonna come out. Now if it's good enough, we'll just go down on the first shot. Here. Here.
feel pressure going this way, pressure going this way, almost like they're contradictory. Mm-hmm. All right, like 10, 12 and 6.
Yeah.
I'm going to shift off the side and change it to 2 and 7. Okay. And that's why you keep being held in this position, even though I'm moving off to the side.
I just keep going back and back and back.
Yeah. Yep. Yep. Okay. Let's begin.
And I did. You guys are doing really well.
What's interesting in this is that it is a forward-leaning thing, so it makes it look like inherently it's aggressive, which just jams up my space and makes me have to push you away. This is a pulling thing to this position, but I just happen to be in a forward-leaning space in my end. That's what's on. You know, I've got a fiery tumi with a very kind of reverse windy movement. Mm. So what I don't want this to be is a move out of the way, come into the e-hen. In too much time, he will have nailed me. I need to have this be a windy movement, but that e-hen is just there. And that's where I end up. So that's how you run into this more, right? I'm pulling you into this, and this just happens to be in your way. So, if you feel comfortable with it, so instead of coming out around, getting into this position, you guys are doing well, and then putting your hand and shifting into this E hand, arrive at the E hand. All right, take out that back and forth. All right, and you'll find that pulling around that fist fit in there, even though they kind of don't seem like they will. It almost seems like you're invading space, which you are, but he will contort. All right, and that's one of the things about this lesson is putting yourself in a body, in a position, so when they arrive, they'll actually contort themselves to fit. Not touching them and making them contort. He's gonna do it just because he's gonna have no choice. My fist will be there. He has no choice. It looks like I'm pushing him, but I'm actually, anything? I'm pulling him into it more, which is making you go backwards. Right? You feel that?
Yeah.
It's not stand up, just it's not me pushing with this arm and pushing him back. It's me pulling this arm, which in default pulls him into my fist, and now he moves back. I'm putting the pressure here to make the effect up here. Alright, which is unique. Alright, we're gonna go like this guy.
Alright. It's like I'm walking into a
right. Right, yeah, it's like a limbo bar.
Yeah.
And he has a limbo bar, and I'm like, come on, and he's like, no, that's exactly the feeling. He's like, I can't. Versus a limbo bar coming and hitting him and pushing his neck back. All right, it's a different thing. It's something that your balance isn't like, used to. And so your body will contort around it to get to here, and then by the time you try to figure out how to get around it, there's too much pressure, and you're on the ground there. Okay? All right, go ahead. Let's emphasize. Let's emphasize the proximity a little bit more to disrupt him even more. So as he comes in, let's not be out here like this and see how far I am away. This way, the closer I get, the more it upsets Matt. All right. To the point in time, I'm actually in between his legs. This makes for an interesting step out, but it can be done. And I want, especially the higher levels, to get there. To see how the hell do I get out of here? All right, I want you guys to experience this. But also, Matt, it's a horrible experience for him. It's one thing if I'm in an E-hand like this, nothing, right? No big. That's different. I want him there. All right, let's play with that distance and see if we get close. So the fact that I want my legs are actually in between his legs. And then we'll look at how to get out from that. All right, you ready? So most everyone here is getting pretty good at that. So now what I want you to do is I want you to shift the outgoing leg. All right, this will change it. It will change the pressure that you have on the person. Let's put around in real quick. So it's very easy. Ooh, well, it's not easy, but I'm here with her and I'm leaning forward. And I go forward and I move this up. Very easy for me to keep the pressure on you because I'm kind of laying right down on top of her. And that this shift, picking this up, actually makes it worse. And it's also very easy if you don't know this part. If I step out, boom, Lynn just goes away. You know, I release all the pressure because I'm over this lane. But can we? We can. I give her here. I know I need pressure going this way and this way. I'm going to maintain that as I step out with that. All right. I still have to have that pressure going from that 12 and that 6 to that 7 and the 2. But I can. It enables me now, if I know that, I can now step out with this lane and do more. All right. Gives me more options. It's easier to start like this because I have more down pressure. But if I'm here and this pit comes out this way, I can still do the same thing. But you can't if you don't know the fact that you have to keep that pressure down. All right?
It's the 7 and the 2 that counts.
7 and the 2 is what counts, that's correct. All right? So if you think you got this pretty good, try stepping out with this leg, but maintaining that posture on that part. Okay? Good. You kind of thought, like, this kind of looks like an Soto Gakkai, kind of. But you would never start, well, not never, but if that night I like this, I would not start in Soto Gakkai. I would probably do 18 different variations of throws, or just jump him a couple times. Solo rapid probably would not be the call from here. But I'm ending up going the same place. Well, this gives you the ability now to understand that if I extend to here, to here, to here, great, the Soto Gakkai actually can work. Even though you started from what you see, it's simply a Soto Gakkai kind of like this, right? And I'm shifting and moving from here, we're kind of new. Not down the center like this. Much less two. In a Soto, you're holding on to me. In this one, you're not holding on to me. I'm like, I got you. But what if we happen to be in this position? Can we do the same thing to him? We can. So now because he's holding on to me, I can actually I'm gonna start over here and I'm gonna go out of a Soto position to get back to a Soto position using this. I'm going to pull him around. Like we have been, but I'm going to pull him around because he's holding on to me. I'm going to still kind of cut his arm. So like I was doing here, and I'm going to do it here. You see that? This hand is still going to go into here because it's right here already. I'm going to move it to here. I'm going to get down to center, and we're going to give him the same feeling. And now. Okay. The only real change is honestly the fact that I have to roll him. Interesting transition because if I just stand here like this, I can't roll your arm, won't move. Because it has to happen as I move. Make sense?
Yep.
You guys kind of see this. So we're here, kind of still the position. I'm like, oh, I don't want to go over there because I see his buddy. Oh, crap. Whoa. Now I can get him in between. Now his buddy has to jump on him to get over him. That's good for me. All right, so we see it? We see the change, the variation?
Okay. So you are kind of grabbing and actually...
Kind of, but there's less of a grab there than you think. It's more the fact that if I can bring my arm under here like this, you automatically kind of go, right? And so I'm really getting just kind of maybe pushing the elbow in and up this way a little bit. Mm-hmm. I could and grab on and go. But stay right there for a second. If I don't move, I can't do it. No matter how hard I get, the fact that I'm going to move, now I can do it. All right, so it has to be in relationship to you getting back on their center line. Okay.
You're moving the elbow toward your belt line.
But the belt line's moving out of the way. Right, or it won't work. I can't do one and two. I actually have to do them both at the same time.
They both have to go at the same time. Have to.
Yeah. Have to. It won't work if you don't. If I did it the other way and I moved my... Can't do it that way either. I can't go one and two. I can't go two and one. I have to go one, two. Have to happen at the center. This is a nice transition this is look at. All right, good. And now that we know how the person's supposed to feel, right? Let's old man this. Sweet comes in. All right. And just take him right to it. Right? Let's cut out the angles a little bit. I know I need to get him to feel this way, right? I need to keep him feeling that way as I go around him. Okay. Now, you can tell I'm not punching him in the face. It's not a, I mean, I could,
whack and do that. I mean, that is an effective technique, but I'm humble and frail and people. Oh no, I don't play all right. Okay? Now that you know the feeling you need to impart on them, throw away the angles or soften them greatly and just, oh, and just be there. Okay? Go.
Questions.
Thoughts, questions, concerns? It's an interesting one because it's a very odd, unique attack angle, and there's a lot of transition through it that has to maintain a certain spinal structure. So that's why I like this. It looks, one of those things that looks really simple at the beginning, like, oh, just go and bash him in the neck and then go and take him down. How simple is that? And then when you try to do it, it's like, that didn't work at all. It's like, oh no, it's this, and it's, oh, it's, oh, oh, oh. And it's like, it's one of those things that looks, in reality, it's totally the opposite of what it looks like. This is why Hashi always says, you can't just watch videos of people doing things and go, oh, that's a kata. Because you'll miss all of the magic inside. And so you have to like come and work with somebody who actually has seen it and knows it and been taught it, because it's like, no, that's not, if you just saw that on like Akbar or something and then just started doing it, you would be so flummoxed. And think it was like, oh, it's just this massive shock to the throat. And it's like, I don't know why he has to go around him all the time, because I just punch him on the ground every single time. It's like, yeah, because he's not doing that at all. And showing you so many other things. So, questions, thoughts? Okay, the kamae for the week is doko no kamae. We looked Wednesday at kind of doko no kamae punches, and again, like why doko versus kamishi monchi? You know, why would you have this here? You know, or why would you have it here? You know, what's the point? You know, point is mainly is because a cover. We can use it to pull out things. We can actually use it to ride punches and move out the side. But also very good for multiple attackers. Like if I get mad, I got Adam, I have a shot at it. Yeah. I would just be here with him and ignore Adam. You know, like I'm not very smart. I'd be here. So now, boom, I have opportunity to attack from both sides. All right. So we looked at it from punches. Now I want to look at it from grabs. How do you use don't go from grabs? So I'm here, and let's actually just look at this grab. Ah, I'm actually just going to go off into a don't go no kamae for the side. And this will be pretty easy because you guys can kind of never work in the exact end with the same thing with the bump. I'm gonna pull this up, which is gonna pull his hand, right? It's that draw out. I'm just gonna go into it. All right, but what I really want you to pick, what I really want you to do is this aspect, not this aspect. All right, this is inconsequential. You can use it and add fun later, with other things. I mean, you know, great, wicked fun. But I don't want it to be a punch down. Similar to the first thing, I want him to be pulled into it. So I'm just, oh no, Adam. Ah. And there's, we'll be using that doko to get out of there. We've seen Sishi Manji, but I find that doko actually does a better job at pulling, because then I have to have this too. Because if he lets go and tries it, if I was here, now I have that cover. And then great for only Gadaki's not half a favorite. All right, so we get to jump into those. All right, so you guys have seen this before, so I'll let you do either one. Grab, stepping off to the side, either go straight into the doko and take them down. And after you get that a couple times, go straight into the doko and then turn. Nail them down. That's a tough position to be put in there. You have to make some alterations, but anybody green belts can try it, please. Okay, nobody less than that. All right, makes sense, go ahead.
Everyone's
experiencing the same exact thing. It's not a surprise, though. No offense. So, remember in the last technique how we kind of rolled this into here? All right, there's kind of like a twisting and pulling of them. What if I imagine if I did that this way, right? I pulled them out this way. What if I took out the twist and I just notice how much he's being pulled this way. That's just there, okay? And so what I'm seeing is, and again, I'm being really picky on this because it's the
it's part of what I see as something that's really helps with Doko, Doko gives you, is I'm not just pushing straight there. Notice I went straight there. Like, my ankle really didn't change at all. My chest did not open. I went just straight there. Now, can I hit him and do something? Oh, absolutely. There's no doubt I can throw something in there, whack, and then rip it into him. Yeah, totally works. Let's be better than that. As I go there, I'm actually going to give him a little bit of this. So I'm going to pull this hand out that way as I go. So, whoa! So now he's being pulled into the hand. He's just like he was being pulled into the punch before. Say this hand is here. He's being pulled into it. I'm not hitting him with it. Okay? Or I don't have to touch him. But not this. Open. Almost like you're drawing a bow. Like, I gotta shoot this up. Like, I'm around a corner. Okay?
Yeah. If you're, I haven't done it yet, but if you're going into the Oni Kodaki, do you still want to do that?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, because actually, since you're better for the Oni Kodaki.
Okay.
Here? Because I'm now right closest. It's right up there. If I just shoot cross like this, I invariably have to close. Whoa! Here. Man, I'm right. Whoa! I'm right there. I don't have to do anything to get that arm closer because that chest right there.
Thank you.
Okay, good. Gyroscope talk. Early, I'm seeing people stiffening up with this. Which is, of course, it's going to be, I mean, I'm holding on to some of your ass, and like, don't touch him and pull him over here and get him off balance. So they still go, yeah, I am. All right, because I'm trying to show you that the position works very well, right? But there's some tricks to it. Number one, I'm not doing this. All my weight's on this leg.
Oh, well, that made a huge difference on you, didn't it?
Right? So I'm not turning in and keeping this gyroscope over here and here. Yeah, I kind of get the space, but I don't have him. So first thing in this gyroscope, as you start turning this out, shift your weight to this side. Totally free. All right, totally free. If you want to, yokoruki out. Let's try that to start. Then you'll get the feeling on that side. Rotate, turn full, full, full. Hips then come out. Oh, down to a yokoruki. All right, fully on this one. All right, go, do that first. Rotating into this weight shift. I'm not just here going like this. I am rotating, like almost like I'm walking over there. All right, so please get that. And it gives me great practice. So rotate into that weight shift. And then, okay, sorry if I didn't emphasize that rotation in the beginning. Please. Sorry about that. So now, let's take this gyroscope, let's take this pull out, all right, and let's actually kind of go back to the first one we did the other day, but really concentrate on like this aspect that we had from the ground, right? You understand what I'm saying? Like this turn, weight shift, pull. Okay, he throws a punch. Whoa. Okay, shit, I take it down. I really don't. I really, you can take it however you want. What I want to see is, can we get this, that whole takeout, like we were doing when he was holding on to us, can we get that mid-air? So almost, I could pick this up. I could go in Hicho if I want, but I'm gonna call it Doko. He's gonna run to the space here. Whatever. Do you see what I'm saying? Do you see this in here? Do you see it? Okay, good. Now started with him coming at you with a punch. Okay.
Alright, good. I'm gonna violate literally what I just said.
When do you move?
in these situations. Adam comes out. At what point in time do I decide to go this way? The earlier, is it later? Obviously, I have to make some type of connection. Is it late tree? Is it early tree? Yeah, it could be all of them. But really, what I'm looking for is the ability that this isn't settled yet. That he, just as like I said, I'm shifting my way, I'm making sure he's not, either he's as fully shifted or he's not quite there yet, so I can manipulate him. He's in the process of going from here to here. So I said, let's throw the punch. One, ooh, right there. See that little? I gotta get him before he gets to here. All right, once he gets to here, then he's totally set and I'm just trying to move his eyes. So thirdly, it would be really nice if I could get him there. This would be the perfect time. This is one-legged table. All right, and so this these early tree things, he comes in very easy because he's one-legged table for that second that that foot has to cross over. All right, this may be too much for this, it's too much for the class. If you don't understand what I'm saying, perfectly fine, okay? But I don't quite get him there. I get him, that foot starting to come down, but he hasn't quite fully shifted. I still have time to shift and move him, to pull him out past where he wants to go, to interrupt him before he gets there, all right? But once he gets there, I can't do anything. Too late, boom, all right? Switches. So what you have to understand, not just is your weight shift, it's his weight shift. And what's going on with their transition. This is where I say sometimes it's like a lava lamp, right? You're the big brown ball, I'm the little tan ball, and you're pushing me out of the way, and then I can pick a side and I said, no, I'm going over this. Okay? We've done whole seminars just on the fact of, I'm gonna go right here, all right? And now I want you to push forward this side and try to attack me. Crazy frustrating. Why does that happen? It's because the second he swings himself to one legged table, all mine. Yeah. All mine. Right. Yep. Good. Yeah. All mine. You see that? I wasn't holding him hard, but I was preventing that shoulder from coming forward. So the second he threw that hip, yeah. Okay. And so is that. We have to pay attention to what's going on in him. So now, as you're doing this with your gyroscope, pay attention to what's happening in their gyroscope too. And how they're having to shift and turn and intercept before it gets there. Alright? Understand and blend in and move them. Okay? Very difficult. Alright? Pay attention to your gyroscope, it's hard enough. Pay attention to yours and somebody else at the same time? Damn.